All right, so hi everyone, it's Renaldo here. Time for a serious video quickly. I know that I've been joking around for the last couple of days with regards to videos with the Superfans, but I want to address something serious. The Department of Sports, Arts and Culture came out with a statement that pretty much attacks anybody that questions the money spent on these Superfans. And what is being said in the statement is very problematic, especially considering the fact that taxpayers' money is being spent. Now, most of you might not have a problem with your tax money being spent, and that's fine. And this is not an attack on Mama Joy. I think there's no dispute that she is a super fan, the same with Boeta. However, people seem to miss the point here. The point is that what procedures are being followed? Who is the department making decisions on behalf of? And these are questions that we need answers to. And you'll understand what I'm saying when I'm talking about the sheer arrogance of the department to call people what they called them. And I'm going to do this video a little bit differently. I'm going to read what was being said, and then I'm going to respond by reading what I posted on social media, asking the spokesperson and the department to give clarity on a couple of questions that I've got. Now, you might not like me, and you can call me a racist and you can call me whatever you want, but at the end of the day, I just want clarity on why only specific individuals are chosen. And it's got nothing to do about their race or their gender. It's got everything to do with the fact of what about other previously disadvantaged people that have not been overseas once, that have not been outside of their community. It's not about I want to send a white person or a colored person, but I mean, obviously a lot of people out there will make it about race because it's the easiest thing to do. And also just to address, a lot of people seem to have had a problem with me calling or using the term prostitute. Let me just clarify one thing here. When I made that statement, I was referring to the department pimping them out like prostitutes. So not once did I call Mama Joy a prostitute or Boeta a prostitute. That's not what my intention was. If you picked it up that way, then it's obviously you trying to take away from the message that was that the department is pimping these individuals out to an international community to try and get exposure for South Africa. That is the point that I was making. Now, if you would like to read the department statement, you can go and do so by just Googling it or checking on X, and you'll probably find the statement there from the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture. I'm going to read to you the problematic statement. In that statement, it says, "It cannot be correct for South Africans that are refusing change to use the Rugby World Cup to push the underlying racism and patriarchal tendencies to bully and insult." Now, you see, as soon as a department uses racism and patriarchy, you know that you have to go deeper. Because now the question is, what are you hiding? Why are you insulting tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of people that would like to know, how this money is being spent and why only one or two or three people are constantly being chosen? Because that's what's happened. Mama Joy has been supported by the department for well over 9 years now. Why is she constantly the one that gets to go and travel the world? Why not give it to somebody else to experience it for the first time? Maybe a young up-and-coming rugby player from a previously disadvantaged area. Just saying. But anyway, with that being said, here is the statement that I wrote, and I'm going to read it now. Dear Zamasa Velapi and Sports, Arts and Culture, I note with great concern your recent statement that anyone who questions the department's super fan sponsorship is pushing their underlying racism and patriarchal tendencies. Your blatant disregard for obvious questions surrounding the super fan sponsorship and how it works and deflecting of these questions is a clear indicator that something isn't right and that more questions need to be asked. Not once has the department answered questions on how these individuals were selected or whether there was even a process open to all South Africans in order to benefit from this project. I therefore ask these questions in the public domain for full transparency from the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture. Number one, since what date has the Department of Sports assisted representatives to attend events inside and outside of the country as ambassadors of South African sport? Number two, how many people is the department currently supporting with these initiatives and how are they selected? Number three, What is the cost breakdown per individual from when the financial support started till today? And please provide a breakdown of each individual and the cost associated with them. Number four, does a department have a revolving policy that benefits more than just the people selected? Meaning, can people apply to the department to become ambassadors? These questions are critical in understanding why athletes who are selected to represent our country need to turn to private funders, because the Department of Sport, Arts and Culture has on many occasions claimed that it doesn't have funding to support these athletes. How is it possible then that athletes who have the skills and ability to fly our flag high on an international stage struggle to get support from your department, but people who sit in the crowd hoping to appear on television for 10 seconds during a match receive a fully paid for trip on the taxpayer's dime? What is of great concern is the fact that one of the superfans has within the last 12 months been to 3 World Cups and has benefited greatly from the department, whilst athletes chosen to represent South Africa have to do crowdfunding and rely on private funding to represent our country on the global stage. This isn't a question of racism or patriarchy. This is a question of what is ethical and right when it comes to promoting our sportsmen and sportswomen in South Africa, regardless of the color of their skin or what gender they belong to. Regards. And that's it. That is what I would like answers to. So I've asked it in a transparent and open manner. And now let's see if the spokesperson and the department will respond to this. Thank you.